Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Android 11 Beta 1 was released to anyone that has a device that's compatible. And that means anything from the Pixel 2, 2 XL, 3, 3 XL, 3A, 3A XL, 4, and 4 XL. Currently, those are the only supported beta devices. And if you have one of those, you can download it pretty easily. And if it's over the air, you enroll your device into Android's beta program. You'll see there's the website there, and it was about 293 megabytes to download. If you're going to install it yourself using a computer, it will be about 2 gigabytes. Now let's take a look at the build number, and then we'll take a look at everything new. The build number, as you can see, it says 11 and then RPB1.200504.018. And this particular update has some new features in it compared to the developer previews that were out before it. Now I covered most of those previews, and if you haven't seen those, there's a bunch of little details covered in each one of those. I'm going to cover the major changes. Now if you want to try this for yourself, just be warned that it may have stability, battery, or performance issues, and they particularly warn against anyone that's using accessibility because some of those features may not work. Now with this update, the first thing they've changed is they've updated it with a bunch of different changes under styles and wallpapers. So if you go to style and maybe you want to create a new style or a custom style, you can do that. We'll hit next again. There's some new options and there's a bunch of new shapes as well. So if you don't want your icons to be round, you want them to be sort of a squircle or a square or any of these other shapes, you can do that. And then you can customize everything else if that's what you want. So you have that option as well. So that's really nice. Now they've also updated dark mode on this particular device. So if you're in dark mode, we'll go to settings and you'll see there's some glitches here and there, but we'll go into display and then we'll turn on the dark theme. Now you can do that from the menu here at the top as well. So if you want to just switch between dark theme or not, you can do that. But I wanted to show you that there's a new menu where you can turn it on based off sunrise to sunset. And that's something I usually leave, so it just changes throughout the day. Now, if I go back to the home screen, you'll see that they've updated it so that the menus look more as though they're dark. So if I press and hold, you'll see everything's nice and dark to match the dark theme. It's a nice little update. Now, also when we're in that dark mode, they've updated the menus as well when you're in settings. So settings icons have been updated. They look a little bit nicer, and it's just updated specifically for dark mode. Now, I usually don't have dark theme on when I'm using a video because it's too reflective and you can see everything. So I do use it throughout the day, but it switches by itself. Now with Android 11 Beta 1, there's now app suggestions, and I've actually moved my icons up one so that I can show you app suggestions because it was turned on by default. But then once I turned it off because it was sort of invasive, it actually kept my icons up here. Then when I went to turn it back on after I had repositioned my icons, it didn't work properly. So there's a little bit of a bug there. But if you go into app suggestions on the home screen, it's been in the app list for a while, turn it on, go home, you'll now see suggestions. So it's based on the most used app. And then if you press and hold, you can actually pin the app based on the suggestion, of course. So it's whether or not you want to use it. It's fine. It just gives you suggestions, but it does take up another row instead of having whatever you want on the bottom row. So just keep that in mind, but it's a nice little feature if you want to see the suggestions throughout the day. If not, we just turn it off, they disappear, and then you have to reposition your app icons. Now with notifications, there's some significant updates as well. And something I really appreciate is they've broken it into sections. Now you can see at the top here, I have something different going on. Now this is actually media resumption options, and they have to be turned on in developer options. But maybe you have Google Play Music or switched over to YouTube Music, or maybe you're using Spotify, it will show up here. And with media resumption, if you have that option turned on, just search for it in your settings. You can now pick which device you want to send the audio to just by tapping on the button at the top. So again, if we go up here, we can hit phone and it will pop up. The same is true if we go over to say what's playing on YouTube, you can do the same thing. Pick where you want the audio to go. So it's a really nice option. It's in the top here and it's in media resumption, like I said. Now, some people are actually seeing it on the lock screen with media resumption as well. I'm not seeing this. You'll see it just shows what it is and then it unlocks quickly and I don't really see anything different. But you have some new options in the notification center if you have that. Now another thing is they've categorized notifications. So let me text myself quickly so I can show you what I mean. So you'll see with notifications, we now have some new sections. We now have our conversations, as they're calling it, although sometimes it's labeled, sometimes it's not. Then we also have alerting notifications and then silent notifications. And so you have these sections now, and you can select what you'd like to do with them. So if we press and hold or long press, we can now make this a priority, and it will show on top either as a conversation or a bubble, which we're not seeing bubbles just yet, but I'll show you that in a moment. We can have it alerting or silent. So if it's priority, it will actually override do not disturb. If we go into our settings here, you see that we have bubbles, and we can turn bubbles on or off, or make this a conversation. We have some new options how to handle this. Now, this will work within other messaging apps as well. Now, if you've ever used Facebook Messenger, you'll have this option for a bubble. And this is what the bubbles look like if you have bubbles turned on for your different messaging apps. Now, developers will need to enable this, allow it to work properly, and then you'll be able to move the bubble around. If someone messages you, it will just pop in as a bubble. And if you want to dismiss it, you can just dismiss it like that. It's a nice new feature that will be there, hopefully, once it's launched. Now, there's another option as well. Whether or not it sticks when the final version is released is hard to say, but if we swipe over here, you'll see that we have screen record. And if we hit screen record, we can record audio and show touches on the screen if we're recording that screen recording. So we can turn this on, hit start, and now you'll see that it shows touches, it'll show swipes. We'll tap on here to stop, and then we can go to our screen recording. We'll open it with photos. And you'll see that it's working, and it kind of works okay. The audio isn't great. Hopefully it will improve over time, but it's something that's there, and I hope they keep it. Now, another feature that's new to picture in picture is something I hope they keep as well, and that's that you can resize it. So here's my video on the Pixel feature drop. We've got our window, and I had a hard time getting this to resize, but basically you can drag it around and you should be able to resize it. Sometimes it works. You can't just do it with two fingers. You can sort of drag and get it to resize. I did get it to work once, but then it sort of froze up. So it is something that's there. Whether or not it's fixed in the future is hard to say, but hopefully they keep the option to resize it, and we can resize the window all the way around the display. Now, there's some new controls when you hold the power button, and if we hold power, you'll see that we now have emergency at the top. We have power off, restart, and if I tap the three menu buttons here, we have bug report. We can also add our card for Google Pay, and also we have controls for home. So for example, we've got my Nest controls built in here. You can also have home controls, anything linked to home itself. If I tap on backyard, it takes a second, it connects, and then it will show you my backyard. And so there's not much to see, but it shows you that in real time right from this menu. So it's a really nice way to do that. Now, within the power menu, you may have noticed that screenshots is no longer here. And if you want to screenshot something, they've moved that to recents or multitasking. So if we swipe up here, maybe we want to take a screenshot. We take a screenshot, and now we have the option to share or edit. If we tap on the screenshot, we can edit it. And this is very similar to iOS, but we could circle that, and then we could share it or export it, or we can just delete it. So it's a nice way to do that. Something a little bit new. And they've also added another option here, such as select. So if we go to this menu here, tap on select, it will show you all of the text that you can actually select. So if I tap on this, we can select this text for maybe sharing it somewhere else. This works on web pages and everything else. So it's a nice little way to quickly select something you want. And then of course we can just share anything here with anything suggested. So it's a really nice way to do that. Very simple and intuitive. Now, there are a few more things they've changed when it comes to permissions, and permissions has been updated so that it allows you to set one-time permissions. For example, if I open this app for the first time, it's a GPS app, and it says, do you want to allow it to use your location? So you can say when using the app, only this time, deny. And you can also go into the permission settings and have it ask you every time. Now, if you hit deny multiple times and it recognizes that, Android will prevent this app from actually asking you if you want to use the location over and over. So it's a nice way to do that. It keeps it more secure, and it's really nice to see that they're updating privacy. Now, as far as anything else, well, they've updated core OS components. And what that means is it can now update through Google Play services in system so that it updates particular parts of the components of the operating system. In fact, 12 new modules to keep everything up to date and secure. So we should see more updates seamlessly brought through Google Play services, and you won't necessarily need a full system update. And that is everything new in Android 11 Beta 1. Now, if you want to see all the different controls and granular things that are changed, check out the developer preview videos I showed before. But these seem to be more finalized. We'll see some more betas before the final release as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.